Right, roll a double six to start? Was it the butler in the kitchen with the wrench? Dang, I never did get the hang of this!
Welcome to Mojo Plays, and today we're taking a look at 10 censored moments in LEGO Marvel games.
The handle's imprinted, right? Like a security code?
It's a very, very interesting theory.
For this list, we're taking a look at the various times where scenes and characters had to be toned down for LEGO Marvel Super Heroes, LEGO Marvel's Avengers, and LEGO Marvel Super Heroes 2. Which of these censors did you find surprising? Were there any we missed? Share with us in the comments below.
If you're a gamer who loves LEGO and Star Wars, check out our fun-filled new channel, Brick Mojo.
Nice knowing you.
Come have a laugh with us and enjoy daily bite-sized videos on LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga.
You must enact an ancient ritual.
You're picking the real speed, don't you?
See you there.
Swearing!
Loki's scepter must be here. Strucker couldn't mount his defense without it.
Okay, this one is a no-brainer, but if you've seen the first Avengers movie or even Age of Ultron, you'll know that there is a light amount of swearing in the MCU. Nothing severe, just the small ones that kind of show the PG-13 rating and replicate the overall tone of the comic books.
Nobody has to break anything.
Clearly you've never made an omelet.
You beat me by 1 second.
Understandably so, these words have been removed from LEGO Avengers in order to maintain that E for everyone rating, or E for everyone ages 10 and up. You gotta keep it clean for the kids, you know?
There may not be a minimum safe distance.
I need you to make sure the Phase 2 prototypes are shipped out.
Yes, sir.
Ghost Rider.
You two kids better be home by 10:30, or there's gonna be trouble.
Whether you've read the comics, seen the movies, or his appearance in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., you probably already know how intense of a hero Ghost Rider is. His presence is menacing, his powers are satanic, and like Batman, he's about striking fear into his foes. As expected, this all had to be toned down for the first LEGO Marvel game. In LEGO Marvel Super Heroes, Ghost Rider is much more goofy than any of his other incarnations, laughing maniacally like a cartoon skeleton as you explore the Big Apple. No funny drinks here.
But it's a trick.
No, it's much more than that.
Whosoever be he worthy shall have the power.
Another adult aspect in the MCU is the presence of alcohol. If you've seen our 20 censored moments in LEGO games, which if you haven't, you totally should, wink wink, nudge nudge, you'll recall we pointed out the complete absence of a scene that featured mimosas in LEGO The Incredibles.
I'm no expert, Stark, but shouldn't a party have entertainment?
Well, in LEGO Avengers, a scene that featured beer and alcohol in general was altered to keep things PG for the kids, replacing the bottles and mugs and tankards with milkshake cups. At least it adds to the carefree and innocent charm we've come to expect from LEGO.
The handle's imprinted, right? Like a security code?
It's a very, very interesting theory.
Cloak and Dagger.
Which means Cloak and Dagger are gonna have to utilize all their fancy new powers in order to escape from the lab and the bad guys.
In case you aren't familiar with this duo, Cloak and Dagger are two heroes who possess the powers of manipulating the Dark Force dimension and can conjure up life-draining daggers respectively. Both of their backstories are rather grim as they touch upon crime related to drugs and greed.
Story is, there are a couple of kids, Tyrone and Tandy. They get along, but find themselves on the wrong side of the tracks. We've all been there.
LEGO Marvel 2 went and lightened things up a bit when they were added in as DLC. Now they were just two teens who got themselves into a mess where they gained powers from a mad scientist. Nothing super remarkable besides Gwenpool narrating the whole story, really.
You know how it goes. The kids get in the way, end up acquiring devastating powers. He's Cloak, she's Dagger. Cloak and Dagger, get it?
A quick end for Quicksilver.
No. Go on. You were saying?
This is arguably the more famous example of the LEGO Marvel games needing to censor certain scenes. In Age of Ultron, Quicksilver manages to save Hawkeye from one of Ultron's pawns by running in front of him and hastily creating cover. Sadly, it cost him his life.
You didn't see that coming.
LEGO Avengers retains the death, but it loses all sense of tragedy. Quicksilver is no longer riddled with bullets, but with splotches of ice cream. We know LEGO wouldn't want their brand associated with violent acts, but for as funny as this may be, it also just doesn't make much sense.
You didn't see that coming.
Howard the Duck. When folks think of Howard the Duck, they aren't thinking about the very few cameos he's made in the MCU, they're not even thinking about his line of comics. No, everybody who hears Howard the Duck thinks about that god-awful movie from 1986. And I know how bad it is. I own the 4K print of it. You can take my word for it. This movie was where Howard was genuinely an unlikable character in the worst ways possible and became a part of one of the most notorious romance scenes in movie history. And if you've seen the movie, you know what I'm talking about.
I've got a headache.
And I got the aspirin.
Be gentle.
That Howard is thankfully not present in LEGO Marvel 1 and 2. This Howard fits a little more in line with the comics, and he is also quieter, and he quacks when he jumps, which is really, really cute. Not another word is said, and that's a shame because we all know he talks like in the comics. When will Howard get the justice he so deserves?
All this smoke, murder on the sinuses.
Ant-Man and the Really Useful Engine.
So Ant-Man, he got all ambush and stuff, but my man, you know, he managed to fight his way out. And he let that dude have it, you know, like bam, bam, bam.
Unlike our other entries, this moment of censorship has nothing to do with anything bad. Nothing concerning swear words, death, alcohol, dark backstories, nothing of the sort. However, this was still worth pointing out. Many who saw Ant-Man will recall an iconic and hilarious fight between Ant-Man and Yellowjacket that took place on a Thomas the Tank Engine train set. And let me tell you, as somebody who grew up with Thomas, seeing that fight really took me back. This scene is referenced at the end of the Ant-Man DLC in LEGO Avengers, right at the end cutscene. Unfortunately, there is no sign of that really useful engine, and it's obviously because of licensing stuff and development costs and everything else pertaining to legal and money. Instead, Thomas has been replaced with a generic LEGO train, and that's a shame. We really could use some LEGO Thomas sets.
And with some help of some, like, really skilled people, you know, he saved the day, man.
Agent Coulson's fate.
Move away, please. You like this? Even I don't know what it does.
Compared to Quicksilver, Coulson's fate was way more heavily censored, and whether it was handled in the best way all depends on how you look at it. Upon reaching the scene where Loki escapes his cell on the helicarrier, players will relive Coulson's tragic death in a more cartoony approach. Loki appears behind him, prepared to whack Coulson on the head with his scepter. The camera cuts just as Loki brings down the scepter. Why this was altered so heavily, we'll never know. But it's really, really weird.
You lack conviction.
I don't think I'm
the Punisher.
See this face? It's not a happy face. And it's all because of joyriding crooks tearing up and polluting the streets in their trucks.
Now, the Punisher is a character we'd never expect to see anywhere close to the LEGO brand. Granted, he was in a Spider-Man set, but that's besides the point. This is a tough-as-nails, ultra-gritty guy who is often depicted with some heavy firepower in his hands. You know, like assault rifles, shotguns, RPGs, and the like. Well, in the first LEGO Marvel game, he doesn't wield a weapon that looks remotely like his arsenal. It's a little more...
Take my environmentally friendly truck and punish those smoke-spewing death machines.
It's a little more cartoony in the sense that you would expect from LEGO. He's also been turned into a bit of an environmentalist, hiring you to take down drivers polluting the air with their trucks. Never thought Punisher would be much of a green thumb hero, but good on him.
I think our work here is done. Drive safe, partner.
Deadpool.
Hi, I'm Deadpool, and I want a pony.
When it comes to mature superheroes, and we mean mature as in content, not in behavior in this case, no other Marvel character has been so hard R, or in this case, M-rated as Deadpool. This is the merc with the mouth we're talking about, the anti-hero who will drop as many F-bombs as he pleases, spill as much blood and guts as he feels like it, and will do so in the most crude and childish ways possible.
Ah. Reach too stupid!
Worth it.
Both LEGO Marvel 1 and 2 remove this aspect and lean more into his jokester personality. He and Gwenpool just hang around, make a few wisecracks, dance maybe, and that's it. He's very much here just for the adults. Let's hope the kiddos don't dig deeper than the LEGO games, alright? You kiddos aren't ready for that. Go play LEGO City Undercover or something, alright? We'll talk to you when you're older.
Until next time, stay classy, kids! Roll credits.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, there's more where that came from.